Hello, this is James Pickles, Phast and Safetti product owner. In this video, I'm going to explain how to view dispersion and radiation results in three dimensions within Phast. We can view dispersion results in three dimensions using the models within a pressure vessel, atmospheric storage tank, long pipeline, or warehouse model. In this example, I have a leak model within a pressure vessel. So I'm going to use this model to view the dispersion results in 3D. To be able to view thermal radiation results in 3D, you must use the standalone models, and we can view thermal radiation results in 3D for jet fires and for pool fires. For the leak model, you would set up this model in the normal way. For the standalone models, there are certain settings that you have to ensure are enabled in order to get the results in 3D. So within this jet fire, on the radiation calculations tab, you must ensure that radiation contours is checked. And then on the radiation contours tab, you must select either radiation footprint, side view, cross section, or a user defined contour plane. To get the results in 3D, it doesn't actually matter which one of these you select, but you must select one of them. On the workspace node, there's also some options that we have to ensure are checked. If we want to get dispersion results in 3D, we need to check 3D dispersion. If we want to get radiation results in 3D, we must select the radiation shielding option. On the parameters tab, we have the 3D viewer parameters. You must define an appropriate grid size and resolution for the 3D viewer. This will be covered in a separate video. Also within this model, I've incorporated a CAD geometry. Now the CAD geometry has no impact on the results whatsoever. They don't affect the dispersion and the radiation results. This CAD geometry model has just been included to give the results some context. Also, incorporating CAD models within Phast will be covered within a separate video. Once your calculations have been run, you can right click on the models to generate the 3D results. So to view dispersion results in 3D, I can right click on this leak model and select 3D results. And then what we will see is a three-dimensional isosurface plot for a certain concentration. To navigate this 3D model, we can use the wheel on the mouse to zoom in and out. We can hold down the right mouse button to pan the 3D model, and we can hold down the left mouse button to swivel and tilt the 3D model. To change the concentration of interest within the 3D viewer, we can go to the consequences tab in the ribbon, and you'll see here this isosurface represents 22,000 parts per million. We can adjust this slider to change the concentration of interest. We can also view multiple concentrations within the three-dimensional viewer. So on the consequences tab, if you click properties, this will display this dialog. I can turn off the ISO surface and turn on an ISO contour plot for a certain plane. So if we turn on the ISO contour plot for the Y plane, you will see here that we're viewing multiple concentrations of interest as indicated by the key towards the top right of the window. And we can adjust the plane that we're actually viewing. So if we adjust this slider for the Y plane, this changes the plane of interest that we're actually observing in three dimensions. To view thermal radiation results in 3D, again, once the model has been run, I can right click on this standalone jet fire or if it was a pool fire, and select three-dimensional results. And this works in exactly the same way as what it does for dispersion. The 3D viewer will initially show us an ISO surface for a certain level of thermal radiation, in this case 72 kilowatts per square meter. I can adjust the slider to the left or to the right to either reduce or increase the thermal radiation level of interest. And again, I can turn on the ISO contour plots. So let's have a look at a Z-plane ISO contour plot. This shows us multiple levels of thermal radiation as indicated by the key. And we can change the height of interest as well using the slider. We can also have a look at other planes as well. So if we have a look at the Y plane, again we can adjust the slider to change the plane of interest. And for an X plane, again we can move the slider to change the plane of interest. One of the benefits of viewing these results in three dimensions is that all of the 3D calculations have been performed up front. Now what that means is that as we adjust the slider, the three-dimensional plot updates instantaneously. If you're viewing results in the 2D graphs and you wish to view a different plane, then you have to go back into your standalone jet fire or pool fire and adjust the plane of interest, and then you have to rerun the model in order to be able to view the results in 2D for that plane of interest. In three dimensions, as I say, all the calculations are performed up front so that as we adjust these sliders, the plot is updated instantaneously. Okay, thank you for listening. And if you have any questions or would like to get in touch, please email digital@dnvgl.com.